Hello students, in present video I am going to explain about 10th problem from depreciation lesson. I am taking this question from Telangana State Intermediate Telugu Academy second year accountancy test book. But this video is useful to all commerce students who want to know about depreciation lesson. On depreciation topic I made 11 videos. Video links are available in the description box. Let us see the question. Nilima traders purchased furniture 20,000 on 1st April 2016. Asset name is furniture. They purchased it on 1st April 2016 for 20,000 rupees. As on 1st April 2016 they bought, we should prepare furniture account from 1st April 2016. Additions are made to the furniture on 30th September 2017 for 10,000 rupees. They purchased additional furniture on 30th September 2017 for 10,000 rupees. There are two assets here. On 31st December 2019, the furniture purchased on 1st April 2016 was sold for 7,000 rupees. On 31st December 2019, they sold first asset for 7,000 rupees. Depreciation is charged at 10% on fixed installment method. Every year, under fixed installment method, straight line method, original cost method, we should provide 10% depreciation on these two assets. The firm closes its books at the end of financial year. Firm is following financial year as accounting year. Means year starts from 1st April and ends with 31st March. Prepare furniture account for 4 years. Let us see the dates. They purchased first asset on 1st April 2016. No? So 1st April 2016. From this date, count 12 months. Then ending date will be 31st March 2017. First year is 16 and 17. On that date, we have one asset, 20,000 worth asset. And it is used for 12 months. For 1 year, we should provide depreciation on 20,000 worth asset on 31st March 2017. Next year starting date is immediate date of this date, 1/4/17. From this date, if you count 12 months, then 31st March 2018 is the last date of second year. And in second year, they purchased additional furniture on 30th September 2017 for 10,000 rupees. 30 September means September month completed. From when they started using that asset? From October 2017. So in second year, this is second asset for how many months firm used? October, November, December, January, February, March. 6 months they used. So on 31st March 2018, firm has two assets. First asset, 20,000 worth asset is used for full year and second asset, 10,000 worth asset is used for 6 months. 6 months from when to when? From 1st October 2017 to 31st March 2018. In third year, that is from 1st April 2018 to 31st March 2019, they have two assets. Two assets are used for full year. So on 31st March 2019, on two assets, 20,000 worth asset and 10,000 worth asset, we should provide depreciation for full year. Come to fourth year. Fourth year dates are 1st April 19 to 31st March 20. In fourth year, first asset was sold on 31st December 2019 for 7,000 rupees. On 31st December 2019 they sold. No. So this date falls in fourth year between these two dates. For how many months they used in fourth year? April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. 9 months they used. From 1st April 19 to 31st December 19 they used. Therefore, on first asset in fourth year, we should calculate depreciation for 9 months. When we should calculate depreciation on first asset in fourth year, on sale date we should calculate depreciation. In previous videos also I explained, if asset is not sold, we should calculate the depreciation at the end of the year. If asset is sold, on sale date we should calculate the depreciation. First asset is sold on 31st December 19, no, on that date only we should calculate depreciation on first asset. For how many months? For how many months they used? For that many months. They used it for 9 months, no? For 9 months we should provide depreciation on first asset in fourth year. When they sell any asset, they get profit or loss. That profit or loss also we should calculate on this sale. Then come to the last date of fourth year. On that day, they have only one asset. Which asset they have? This second asset, 10,000 worth asset they have. Because firm didn't sell this asset. So on that, again we should calculate depreciation. For how many months? Second asset is used from 1st April 19 to 31st March 20. No, for full year we have to provide depreciation on second asset. Let us solve this problem. They purchased the asset on 1st April 16 for 20,000 rupees, no? Debit side, 1st April 16 to bank 20,000. Then last date of 1st year, on that day depreciation we should provide on 1st asset. Credit side, write down that last day by depreciation account, 1st asset cost is 20,000 on that 10%. 2000 is the depreciation on first asset in first year. Now find out the balance carried down. Debit total 20,000 minus credit total 2000 is equal to 18,000. Put the total. Come to second year. Date is next immediate date of this date. 1st April 17. Bring the balance. This balance carried down 18,000. We have to bring on debit side. To balance brought down 18,000. In second year, they purchased one asset for 10,000 rupees on 30 September 17. Write down the date here, 30 September 17. You can write 1st October 17. No problem. When we purchase any asset, we should write bank account now. To bank account. Second asset cost 10,000 rupees. Now come to last date of second year. On that day, we have two assets now. So on both, we should calculate depreciation in inner column. Total depreciation, we should write in outer column. First asset, 20,000 worth asset. For how many months we used? From 1st April 17 to 31st March 18. Full year they used. 12 months they used. 12 months depreciation we have calculated in first year now. Again, you need not to show this calculation in second year. Directly you can take this 2000 rupees. Come to second asset. Second asset cost is 10,000. On that, at the rate of 10%, for how many months we should provide depreciation? Observe, in second year, from when to when they use this asset? On 30 September they bought. September month completed. Count from October. October, November, December, January, February, March. 6 months they used. Therefore, into 6 by 12. One numerator, one denominator we should cancel. ₹500 is a depreciation on second asset for 6 months. total depreciation in outer column. Now find out the balance carried up. Debit total 28,000 rupees minus credit total 25,500 rupees is balance carried down. Now put the total 28,000. Second year is completed. Come to third year, date is next immediate date of this date. 1st April 18, 2 balance brought down 25,500. This is the opening balance of 2 furnitures in 3rd year on starting date. Now come to 3rd year last date. On that day we have 2 assets now. 1st asset is used from 1st April 18 to 31st March 19. Full year they used. Full year depreciation is 2000 rupees now. Write down that. 2nd asset, 10,000 worth asset. In 3rd year, we used from 1st April 18 to 31st March 19. Full year we used. Therefore, 1 year depreciation we should calculate. You cannot take this 500 rupees here. Because in 2nd year, they used it only for 6 months. 500 is 6 months depreciation. But in 3rd year, they used it for full year, no? Therefore, again we should calculate the depreciation. Now, total depreciation in outer column, 3000 rupees. Depreciation on 2 assets for 12 months. Now, find out the balance carried up. Debit total minus credit total, 22,500. Write down here, put the total. Come to last year, balance carried down becomes balance brought down. Date is next immediate date of this date. Balance brought down value is 22,500. This is the opening balance of 2 furnitures in 4th year. On 31st December 19, they sold 1st asset, no? When they sell, we should write that on credit side. By bank, they sold it for 7,000 rupees. Sale date is 31st December 19. Up to that date, they use this asset. Therefore, up to that date only, we should provide depreciation. So, depreciation date is also the same date. Sale date. Generally, we provide depreciation at the end of the year. But in 4th year, as 1st asset is sold on 31st December 19, we should provide depreciation on 1st asset on 31st December 19 only. So, by depreciation on 1st asset I am calculating, this is fixed installment method. The basic feature of this method is every year we should provide depreciation on original cost of the asset. Original cost of sold asset is 20,000 rupees. So 20,000 into 10 by 100 into from when to when they used it. From 1st April 19 to 31st December 19 they used. Means April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. 9 months they used. Therefore, provide depreciation only for 9 months. One numerator, one denominator we should cancel. $500 into $3,1500. $1500 is the depreciation on 1st asset. When asset is sold, we may get profit or loss. That we should calculate now. Leave some space, show the working notes. Place is not there to write the heading. You should write the heading also. Calculation of profit or loss on sale. Procedure is take cost of the asset. 1st asset is sold. 1st asset cost is 20,000 rupees. 20,000 minus total depreciation. 1st asset is used from 16 and 17 year now. 16-17 year, in that year, depreciation on first asset is 2000 rupees. Write down that 2000 in inner column. Second year, 1/4/17 to 31st March 18, means 17-18 is second year. In this year, first asset depreciation is 2000 rupees, not 2500. 2500 includes second asset depreciation also, no? I want to calculate the profit or loss on sale of first asset. Therefore, first asset depreciations only we should take. So, first asset depreciation is 2000. Come to third year. Third year is 1/4/18 to 31st March 19. 18-19 is third year. In third year, first asset depreciation is 2000, not 3000. 3000 is the total depreciation of two assets. We should not consider that value, no. 2000 rupees taken in inner column. Come to fourth year. First asset is used from 1/4/19 to 31st December 19. Only for 9 months we used first asset, and 9 months depreciation is 1500 rupees. Take that value here. Then total depreciation in outer column. 6,7,500 rupees. Now find out the book value. Cost minus total depreciation is book value. From 20,000 deduct 7,500 rupees. 12,500 is the book value. On sale date, first asset value is 12,500. 12,500 worth asset is sold for 7,000. They sold for less value. So they got loss. Therefore, first book value we should write 12,500 minus sale value 7,000. Then 5,500 is loss. Loss we said we should show in account credit side. Why we should show on credit side? And what is the entry for loss? These points I explained in 8th problem video. Video link is available in the description box. 5,500 we should write in amount column. For profit or loss, in particulars column we should write profit and loss account. And when you will get this loss? On sale date. Therefore, for loss also write down the same date, 31st December 2019. So, first asset related entries are completed. Now come to second asset. Second asset is not sold by the firm. Means up to 31st March 20, they use the second asset. Therefore, on 31st March 20, we should provide depreciation on second asset. Depreciation we write on credit side, no? 31st March 20 by depreciation account on second asset. Second asset is used from 1/4/19 to 31st March 20. Full year they used. Full year depreciation we calculated in third year, no? 1000 rupees. Write down that amount here. 1000 rupees. Observe one point. In second year and in third year, we wrote depreciation word only for one time. In inner column, we added both. And in outer column, we have written total depreciation. But in fourth year, we are writing depreciation word for two times. And separately, we are showing the depreciations on these two assets. Why? Because in second year and in third year, observe the depreciation dates same. But in fourth year, first asset depreciation we calculated on 31st December 19. Second asset depreciation we calculated on 31st March 20. As depreciation dates are not same, you cannot add two depreciations in inner column. We should show separately. Then find out the balance carried down. Debit total 22,500. Minus credit total 6, 7, 14, 15. Credit total is 15,000 rupees. If you deduct that, 7,500 is the balance carried down. Credit side, 7,500 is balance carried down on last date of 4th year, 31st March 20. Now put the total. Credit side total is also 22,500. In previous problems, only one asset he used to give in the question. When that asset is sold, automatically asset account gets closed. But here, two assets we have. Second asset is not sold. It is continuing for next year also. That is why in fourth year, we have balance carried down. 7,500 balance carried down belongs to second asset. As account is not closed, for next year we have to continue. Due to place problem, I have not written here, but you should write on debit side. Date is next date of this date, 1st April 2020, two balance brought down 7,500. Means from 5th year onwards, with that second asset, we are going to continue the account. So this is all about 10th problem from depreciation lesson. Hope this video is useful to you. Thank you.